slang. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains. I score up in the end zone, do my dance all on a hater. A mover and a shaker, you a novice, I'm a player. I'm from DC, but I'm running through and
going high. I can never switch, not a day in my life. You know me, my dog, stay by my side. Got you gon' ride till we die, die, die. This ain't nothing for the pack. Got 16 sitting in the lack. Whole squad all dressing all black. Every single last one of them got my back. Hey, 20 of us, that's 20 goons. And the ice cream whip, triple scoop. I got 3 strikes, ain't got to lose. When it's all on the line, what you gonna do? Come on, I'm highly favored. Don't wanna play me, no conversation, ain't got time for no debating. It's for the taking, no hesitation, don't try my patience. I'ma pour out 1 foot of set, boy, till there's nothing left. Wanna run to the bread until we all got them baguettes. Hear them footsteps coming, cause we coming for the check.
The NFL on EA Sports brings us to North Carolina and Bank of America Stadium here in Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerged from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Dallas Cowboys. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Mike.
Here we go.
First and 10, Prescott. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Going with a dime look on defense. 2 extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
What's the run? They're running it. Slam.
Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
And force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. Cooper's got it. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 16 in the Dallas first down.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Take this one up close to about the 45. James Bradbury there to make the tackle.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. Oh, Prescott stripped.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because This is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Third and long for Prescott. Looking deep in the direction of Cooper. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Cowboys! Amari Cooper, 68 yards, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter.
Partner, one of the cardinal rules of defense is that if you're in position to make a tackle, you need to make it.
Well, and if you can't make the tackle before that, you just got to knock that ball down, right?
Yeah, something has to happen because we saw the end result there. Missed tackle, he goes all the way and takes it for a touchdown.
Forbath to send it away now following the touchdown. Fielded about a yard deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Greer and the Panthers set to go first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
22 Jet Bomber.
First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. Here's Greer now on second down. This is caught. It's Greg Olsen. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Check.
First. Here's McCaffrey. And he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory. Xavier Woods, the free safety, up to make the tackle.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
Mike 50. Crunch time defense.
Hey. 50. 50 to Mike. 50 to Mike.
Watch the run.
Hey, zoom. Go. Zoom.
To throw on second and 6. Greer. And he's got the hook up to Moore. Good move at the 30. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 28.
And let's face it, that what we just saw there, not a surprise, is it? I mean, this is what he does well. And if you don't tackle him as soon as he catches the ball, this is the end result. Big yardage afterwards.
Got the speed, the agility, so good with run after catch. We're only in the first quarter, so they better get a wrangle and a hold on that quickly.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And what's really difficult to try and defend him is if you want to press him so that you get him on the ground quickly after the catch, a lot of times he'll just run past you at the initial point of contact, and he'll go deep.
Check. Hey, Echo.
Operating in the red zone now, Greer. This will be caught at about the 5. That's a 12-yard gain now on back-to-back plays. Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, stepping back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back.
Recon, 132 fighter.
Now Greer. And incomplete. Curtis Samuel, the intended target, but it'll be second and goal.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
Ready? And over. 54. Hey, Foxtrot.
I'm coming after you.
Ready?
Now Greer on third and goal. And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line.
We're talking about how teams are so competitively matched and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal, that's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know, he hated taking the loss there on third down. So, yes, it's only three, but at least you're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Defense doing their job, really nowhere to run the football.
Yeah, it's almost textbook, wasn't it? Every place he tried to find an open spot, there just wasn't one. Congrats to the defense, no gain.
Call fitting your gaps, right?
I love it. You're exactly right.
Looking to throw on second down. Prescott got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here, up to the 34. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. Came up a little short on the last pass play. They did get 9 yards out of it, leaving him with his third and one. On third down, Elliott. And he will have the first down, but he winds up paying for it pretty good. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
First down, Cowboys.
After 1, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Second down now. It's Elliott, and not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. The Cowboys on third down. A perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This will be 3rd and 5. Prescott off play action. And he'll have his man. That's Cooper. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 30. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Down Elliott, and he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 25.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Hey, watch it.
53. Walk, get wide. Check. Crouch. You go tight. You got tight right there.
We're going to 54. One, three, six.
Now Elliott. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. On third down, it's Prescott. And he fires one that's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it. And the return will stop him well inside their own 20 at the 15-yard line. No doubt, a very disappointing end to what was a pretty strong opening drive.
They had 3 points in their back pocket. It was there for them. If you don't like what you see, just throw it away. Make sure you get those points on the board. Don't get too greedy. He forced it there. You saw the end result.
Greer and the Panthers set to go first and 10 at their own 15. And a short gain across the 15 to the 17-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight.
Rock it. Hey, we heavy on the edges. Heavy on the edges.
Check.
A handoff left. McCaffrey. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. It's a Panthers first down, 17 yards on the play. From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Eddie Weapon.
First and 10 at the 34-yard line.
Hey, watch out. Check Mike 50. Go.
They'll give it up to McCaffrey. Not much there. Maybe a couple up to the 35.
Vision is so important for the man in the middle because his ability to look through all the clutter that's happening in front of him, diagnose a play, and then go make it and finish it, that's when the great ones know that they have the goods.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Now a draw play to McCaffrey. And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41.
I thought that was a good call. Passing situation on second down. They hit him with the draw instead and pick up nice yardage.
Yeah, because the draw, they're thinking pass when they see that initially defensively, right?
Well, you know, in today's NFL, most of the time on second and long when it's a passing situation, pass rushers are on the field and they're only thinking one thing, get to the quarterback. And oftentimes you can bypass them with a running play.
Greer. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. 2 minutes to play in this first half, 7-3, our score. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it second and six. Yeah, give him 4 yards there, it'll be second and six.
Second down six. At the 49-yard line.
6-6, pull it high.
Mike 54.
Haywood.
Let's go, D. 54's Mike.
From just shy of midfield, Greer. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Sean Lee, the linebacker, able to get a hand in coverage.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things.
Hey, Charlie!
Mike 50. 55. 50's the mic.
Watch the run.
Mike's 50. You remember me?
Hey, Orbit.
Let's go, baby.
Get it.
Throwing on third down, Greer. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. 20.
That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off, and it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
He went through all of his rules about getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Watch twist. On second down, it's Elliott, and he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Taking it in from 4 yards out, and the Cowboys, they push out in front further. Forbath, the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Forbath to send it away now following the touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down, and it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops, and if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
Second and six, just inside the 30.
Get the ball. Tight door.
They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. And the Cowboys here on third down bringing in an extra defensive back.
Hey, wahoo!
Y'all playing the wrong football.
Mike's 50.
I'm on.
Hey, alert. Mike's 50. Watch a slant.
Five.
Mike's 50.
Quarterback, don't get nervous now. We ain't beginning to turn you up.
Ready?
From the gun on third down, Greer. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. On fourth down, the Panthers send out Michael Pilardi to kick it away. Back deep is Tavon Austin. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line.
Let's go!
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. On second down, McCaffrey. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
I think if we put together a job description for a middle linebacker, we would start with being able to hold down things in the middle of the line of scrimmage and be able to take on blockers. But how about the guys who can go sideline to sideline and make plays?
Love a guy that can do that. We saw a perfect example of it right there. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. Give him 15 there, and the Panthers have a first down.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
Ready? 15 line.
Better bring it. You better bring it. I'm letting you know right now, you better bring it.
Check 26.
Begin.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The Panthers have the first. It's a gain of 12.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. This is McCaffrey on the give. And after the good gain last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Continues to be a struggle for this offense, and this home crowd, they're growing a little restless here in the second half.
And I think they've just got to look at how they're trying to move the football. Yeah, you want to run it, but maybe you spread it out, maybe some swing passes that can take the place of runs and give you a little more space.
From the 50, here's Greer. Steps away to his left. He'll run it. Oh, now Greer, he fumbled the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. He gained really good yardage. That's what you tell your quarterbacks, right? Get down after you've got the run.
You don't have to prove your toughness. You know, I think that's what a lot of coaches are trying to preach to their guys. Get the yardage, get down, protect the football, and protect yourself from extra hits as well.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
I don't even know why this team showed up.
Check three. Out. Check.
Watch it.
We're going to 54. Why here?
They'll try and get the running game going with Elliott. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think they had three tight ends in on that set.
And these guys are punching really well. I use boxing analogies a lot. A lot of coaches have told me that when you line up to run the football, it's 10 fist fights along the line of scrimmage, right? You've got to win your share. These three tight ends, they almost always win their fist fights.
This is Elliott, and no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47. On second and 9, Prescott. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert
on third and nine.
We're going to 54. Why is
it? Check, check. 59. Hey, man, hey, man. Watch the boot.
Why go kill, kill?
From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10. They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL, and he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time, so make sure you get in shape.
Mike's 50, Mike's 50. Cut, cut, cut. Watch the twist, watch the twist. Mike's 50, Mike's 50.
Hey, high seven.
To throw on third down, Greer. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete. Jeff Heath, the strong safety, able to get in there on the coverage.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth.
Mike 50, Mike 50. Silver, Silver. Mike 50. Mike 50.
They're going to go. It's Greer. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The tank, DeMarcus Lawrence with a sack. Well, they've clearly made a conscious decision here to be more aggressive in the late stages of this game here in the second half.
And I get it. In this situation, you know, if you want to be aggressive out near midfield, you feel good about your defense maybe, or just, hey, I thought I had a proper play call. But how about the guys that just stopped them? How good do they feel right now? Hey, you want to go for it here? We shut you down? They're over on the bench right now feeling great.
Here's Elliott. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. A loss of two there. Second down.
A loss of two. Second and
12
at the 39-yard line.
Hey, kill, kill. Kill, kill. Hey, 47. 54. Charge, charge. 54.
On second and 12, Prescott. He's got a man complete. It's Amari Cooper. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. A gain of 28 yards there and give him the first down.
Check, check. Watch 54. Watch 54.
Lying.
Bang, bang. No, no, no. Off, off, off.
Then we're going to 53.
Show it in.
26.
They'll run on first down. It's Elliott. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
Joker, 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 Joker. Under 10, under 10, 10.
We're going to 54, lying. We're going to 54,
lying. 26. They go to Elliott again. He pushes forward from maybe three down to the 6-yard line.
You got him! You got him! Got him.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we played three quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Here we go.
The Cowboys on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. This will be third and five. They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stuffed them for almost no gain.
And Forbath will put this one through, and they will stretch the lead now to 17-3. So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but they still ate up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
Here we go. 18, Gator.
9:54. Quit talking about it and bring it.
Smith.
Right there. 54, right there, right there. 54 mile. Ricky. Mike 54.
Let's go. 54.
Throwing on second and eight. Greer, he's going to look. And that's caught inside the 35. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. It's a gain of 34.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game.
Hurry, snap.
First down, Greer. That's caught. It's Jarius Wright. And down inside the 15 he goes. It's a Panthers first down, 17 yards on the play.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
Mike 5-4.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Out of the pistol, McCaffrey. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal. Now, yes, a two-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on second and short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right. They did pick up the first down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now because it's a two-possession game. They've got to get there twice.
And he is in. Touchdown, Carolina. Taking it in from 2 yards out as his guys are back within a single score. Solid job up front, really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run, end result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Point after, right down the middle. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. This will be taken in at the one.
All right, partner, get that disapproving look off of your face. He did get it out to the 1-yard line. Yeah, I know. Wasn't the best play in the world. He's hoping his offense can bail him out.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game, and you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
Again, it's Elliott. And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go.
Check to the 154.
Kill. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. He sets to fire deep. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down. And sensing the momentum maybe changing here a little bit, Charles.
Yeah, this defense is going to get off the field quickly, and their offense got them a touchdown last time they had the ball, so they should get another shot.
Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. It's the former Tar Heel back here in Carolina, Robert Quinn. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. This is McCaffrey. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going. On third and long, here is Greer. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. DeMarcus Lawrence in there to drop him as that clock continues to run. And you hate to say it with a rookie quarterback. He's done some good things, but overall, looked a little bit overwhelmed back there, hasn't he?
He certainly has. But in his defense, he hadn't had a lot of time to throw the football. You like the way I said that? In his defense.
In his defense. I got it.
See what I did there?
Yeah. He needs better protection, that's for sure. They snap it to Greer. He's going to let it fly. And it's knocked away and incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. So first and 10 now from the 30.
Rush in, rush in, rush in. Hey, alert three, slam, slam.
SOS, SOS, SOS. SOS, SOS, SOS.
Going to 54. Going to 54. Why ain't?
Minus 50.
Going to 53. Hey, kill. 26.
Elliott. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
So we got man.
Whip.
Watch the whip.
We're going to 54. Why is it?
Check nine.
Check. Fresno.
We're going to 54. Why is it?
Shit.
What do you think?
A 20th carry here for Elliott. A gain of a yard gets him back where they started. Now it's third and 10. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Put that team on the hook. Hey.
No, we're going to 53.
Check.
Watch the ship. Hey. Watch the ship. Tighten up. Kill.
We're going to 54. Why is it?
They'll keep it on the ground. Elliott. And he will get him down a couple yards shy of the first down marker. A nice tackle coming up from his free safety spot. Give him 9 on the carry, but it's not enough. And it'll be fourth down. This is no good. Close but no cigar, just wide right. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. One possession game. Time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. What did you see on that one? Rookie mistake or just good defense?
It was a combo play, but the rookie quarterback, he'll take it all on his shoulders, and the frustration level is evident. You can see it with him. You know, if that's a veteran quarterback, he walks off like he just threw a touchdown pass because he doesn't want to show that to the defense. The young guys, they take it more to heart.
And he's across for the touchdown, and in the final minute, that should just about seal it. Forbath to add the extra point. And the lead is up to 14. Forbath to send it away now following the touchdown. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Jeff Heath. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
Forbath able to convert the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Break.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on, get it done, and maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Buying time to his left. He's going to take off with it. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. And